Hey, what's up everyone? Welcome to my YouTube channel, Life Science with KMD. Today I'm going to explain about biotic stress tolerance in plants through genetic engineering. The main biotic stress in plants are weeds, insects, fungi, bacteria, virus, herbivores and other plants. Genetic engineering for the tolerance to glyphosate. Glyphosate is a Roundup herbicide, is a very effective broad spectrum herbicide that inhibits the enzyme 5-enol pyrivyl cicimate phosphate synthase, which is also called as EPSP, which is essential for the protein biosynthetic pathway of aromatic amino acids such as tryptophan, tyrosine and phenylalanine, which are essential for and also as a precursor for hormones, lignins and other protective compounds such as flavonoids and alkaloids. EPSP synthase uses phosphoenyl pyruvate and cicimate 3-phosphate as substrate to make EPSP. Glyphosate competitively interfere with the binding of PEP to the active site of EPSP synthase. Herbicidal activity of many herbicides result from the specific inhibition of single enzyme or a protein. Many of the targeted pathway are located in the chloroplast. There are three approaches, that is incorporating insensitive EPSPs, overexpression of target molecule, incorporating molecules which can degrade the herbicides. Now, strategies for glyphosate resistance. Overproduction of EPSPs enzyme encode an EPSPs enzyme that is tolerant to glyphosate. Produce an enzyme that inactivates glyphosate. Use a combination of 2 and 3. See, after spraying herbicide onto the field, you can see only the transgenic plants could able to survive, whereas the weeds are already dead. These are some of the examples of plants, transgenic plants, which are tolerant to glyphosate. Source of, like in case of carrot, the source of glyphosate tolerance strain is the cell line selected for glyphosate resistance. Mechanism of glyphosate tolerance is overproduction of EPSPs due to gene amplification. Now, what are the limitations of these transgenic plants? The transgenic food product may be allergy to humans, affect the soil flora, developing superweeds, affect natural germplasm. Genetic engineering for insect resistance. There are two approaches. One is incorporating delta endotoxin sequence from Bacillus thuringiensis, or the second one is incorporating plant derived genes like lectins, proteinase inhibitors, etc. In case of Bacillus thuringiensis, which is a gram positive aerobic sporulating bacterium, synthesize crystalline protein during sporulation. Crystalline proteins are highly insecticidal at very low concentration. This crystalline structure of the inclusion is made up of prototoxin subunit called delta endotoxin. The proteins are non-toxic to mammal and other animals. Cry gene of Bacillus thuringiensis produce protein which forms crystalline inclusion in bacterial spores. The delta endotoxins are soluble in insect midgut and are activated by gut proteases by a combination of alkyl pH between around 7.5 to 8.5. Cleave the protein into small polypeptide, the toxin, which is a toxin. The toxin bind to the surface of epithelial cells in the midgut, induce lesions that destroy the cells, lead to death of the insect. Now, in this picture, this is a Bacillus thuringiensis. From this bacterium, we will transform Cry gene into the plants like corn and cotton, then it is called as BT corn or BT cotton. These plants start to produce BT toxin crystals in their stem and leaf. Once the bollworm start to infect these plants, the crystalline protein or the BT toxin crystals will be ingested by the bollworm. There it get solubilized and get activated. This toxin monomer will go and binds to the insect midgut cells. There it will start to produce pores, which lead to osmotic cell lysis. Then the activation that lead to activation of cell death pathway, due to which the larva will start to die. Now this is the list of BT expressing transgenic crops. Now coming to the limitation, inadequate cry gene expression or reduced cry gene expression due to environmental factor, presence of local cry protein resistant insect population, or development of resistance in insect pests due to inadequate management. Protease inhibitors, they interfere with digestive enzymes of the insect, result in nutritional deprivation, causing death of the insects. According to their specificity, protease inhibitors can be divided into four classes: serine protease inhibitors, cysteine protease inhibitor, aspartic and metalloprotease inhibitor, bifunctional alpha amylase 1 protease inhibitor. The serine and cysteine protease inhibitor inhibit mainly lepidodendron or coleopteron, the most active inhibitor identified in cowpea trypsin inhibitor, transferred into at least 10 other plant species. Protein is an effective anti-metabolite agent, a range from field to storage pest. Serine protease inhibitor result in up to 100% mortality of first instar cotton leaf worm when expressed in tobacco. Alpha amylase inhibitors. Insect larvae secrete a gut enzyme alpha amylase to digest starch. Blocking the activity of this enzyme by alpha amylase inhibitor, the larva can be starved and killed. Alpha amylase inhibitor gene isolated from bean has been successfully transferred and expressed in tobacco. Provide resistant against Coleoptera. Lectin are carbohydrate binding protein found in many plants, abundant in seeds and storage tissue of some plant species. Involves specific binding of lectin to glycoconjugate located in the midgut of the insect. Tobacco plant expressing a P. lectin were shown to be toxic to Lepidoptera. Insect chitinase. Chitin is an insoluble structural polysaccharide that occur in the exoskeletal and gut lining of insect. It is believed to protect the insect against water loss and abrasive agent. Larva feeding on the transgenic plant exhibit severe growth aberration and die prematurely. Other insect resistant gene from plant. Tryptophan decarboxylase from periwinkle was expressed in tobacco. This induced synthesis of tryptamine and tryptamine based alkaloids. Pupal emergence of the white fly decreased as a result of feeding on such plants. Genetic engineering of fungal and bacterial resistance. Host and pathogen show gene for gene relationship. There are two types. One is incompatible reaction and another one is compatible reaction. In case of incompatible reaction, which is found in biotrophic pathogen, like for example obligate parasites such as smuts and rust, allele for resistance in host and those of virulence in pathogen produce specific compounds which recognize each other. When these specific compounds interact, produce resistance response in host. Association with hypersensitive reaction, triggered by certain unique molecules called elicitors of pathogen origin. Elicitors are recognized by a receptor-like molecule present in the resistant plant, initiate severe biochemical reaction, produce reactive or active oxygen species, phytoalexin biosynthesis, cell wall reinforcement, release of hydrolytic enzymes or inhibitor protein, result in rapid cell death. Compatible reaction: allele for susceptibility in host and those for virulence in pathogen produce specific compound which interact with each other to produce susceptible response. Lack of interaction between the product of gene specific resistance response in host found in heterotrophic pathogens. Strategies for resistance: genes encoding insensitive target enzymes, genes specifying toxin inactivation, expression of antibacterial peptides, expression of bacterial lysozymes, genes specifying programmed cell death, RNAi targeting pathogen parasitic genes, expression of heterologous phytoalexin, genes encoding ribozyme inactivation protein, expression of heterologous thionein, ectopic expression of pathogen related proteins, ectopic expression of chitinase, modification of host protein required for infection by pathogen. Genetic engineering for virus resistance: coat protein genes, cDNA of satellite RNA, defective viral genome, antisense RNA approach, ribozymes mediated approach, based on strategies on genes derived from pathogenic virus themselves, pathogen derived resistance, that is disease resistance generated by employing pathogen genes. Coat protein genes: transgenic plants have virus coat protein gene linked to strong promoter, like for example in case of tobacco, tomato and alpha, sugar beet and potato. Expression of viral coat protein gene confers resistance to concerned virus and give measure of resistance to other related virus. Effectiveness of coat protein affected by amount of coat protein produced in transgenic plants and by concentration of virus inoculum. The resistance is due to blocking of the cDNA of satellite RNA. Some RNA virus have a small RNA molecule called satellite. Depending on viral genome, they are depending on the viral genome for their replication, not necessary for viral function. Satellite either decrease or increase severity of disease produced by the virus carrying it. cDNA copy of satellite that reduce disease severity have been integrated into host genome. Expression of satellite has been shown to reduce disease symptoms as well as virus accumulation. Defective viral genome: defective or deleted genome of some RNA or DNA virus disrupt replication of a complete genome of those virus with which they are associated. African cassava mosaic virus, which is also called as ACMV, has two single-stranded DNA, molecule A and B DNAs. In addition, 50% deleted B DNA is also found associated. In tobacco plant containing deleted B DNA integrated in their genome showed reduced systemic spread when infected with African cassava mosaic virus. Antisense RNA approach: produced by intervening cDNA copy of mRNA with respect to promoter in an expression vector, yield full length complementary copy of mRNA sequence, interact with the mRNA molecule by base pairing to form double stranded RNA. Ribozyme mediated approach: RNA molecules that exhibit enzyme activity. Hybrid RNA consisting of tobacco ring spot virus satellite RNA, endoribonuclease catalytic sequence linked to antisense RNA specific to specific gene agonist they are targeted. Strategy consists of producing ribozyme specific to part of target virus genome, to produce cDNA of these ribozymes to integrate it into host plant genome. Thanks for watching my video. Please subscribe to my channel by clicking on subscription button. Subscription doesn't cost you any money. To get a notification, click on a bell icon. Do like and share this video with friends and family. If you have any kind of feedback, do share it on a comment box. Thank you.